Hey everyone, John here from Arise Mortgage. What? Where's the let's do this? Well, this video is going to be a little bit different. I'm doing a new series on YouTube on how to become a mortgage broker, and it'll be catered to those who are going to get or just pass their mortgage broker license. And if this is you, you're probably wondering, well, what's the next step? The next step is to choose your brokerage or team. And we're one of the teams that you should consider. Jokes aside, there are hundreds of brokerages and teams out there, and it's important for you to pick the right one for you. Here are five things to consider when you're choosing a brokerage or team. Number one, what's the split? That's probably the first question everyone asks. The split is how much you share your commission with the brokerage per deal. Generally, if you're new with absolutely no experience, you'll start off with a 50-50 to a 65-35 split up until a certain amount of revenue. And it goes up from there. 50-50 is probably the minimum and will most likely be for your first 5 to 10 mortgage files. Once you get the hang of the role and you can be more independent, your revenue will be higher and your split will be more favorable to you. And keep in mind that you are paying them to train you. You, not them, you are the customer in this transaction. And the help, guidance, and support they give you needs to be worth the price you are paying. And just like every other industry, in this one, you get what you pay for. Higher splits should come with better quality training and support. If the team is offering a new agent an 80-20 split, you can expect they will not be offering a lot of support. Number two, what's the training? Every brokerage is going to say they'll provide training, but ask more about it. It's very important to ensure you get the training and support. How much training are they actually offering? Is it practical training or is it just online training? Who is your mentor going to be? What is their availability to you? Do you have someone to call or text anytime with questions? Or do you need to make an appointment once a week to go over everything? There is no right or wrong answer to this one, but make sure that it is clear from the start what the mentorship relationship looks like. You need to find a mentor that is suited to your personality and that teaches in a manner that suits your learning style. Some people are more self-driven, and a team with less training may be exactly what they wanted. But you need to know who you are and what you need out of the training to be successful. Number three, desk fees and programs. Ask what the monthly costs are and what that includes. Does it include access to programs like FileLogix, Velocity, Purview, CRM softwares, website hosting, email apps, and error and omission insurance, Equifax, credit monitoring, toll-free lines, all these stuff, so many, and so on. Do you have to pay extra for title searches? Do you have to pay extra for a PDF software program or e-signing program? Again, no right or wrong answer here. Some brokerages have no desk fees, but you have to pay for your own access to these programs. Some have a desk fee that covers all this stuff or part of this stuff. Good to weigh this out to find the right fit for you and what these things will cost on a monthly basis. Number four, what's the plan for growth? Choose a team that is just as dedicated to your success at this as you are. Are they genuine about the desire to help you grow? Ask for examples. Who is in the team that is killing it? Interview agents who currently work there and ask the hard questions. What is their turnover rate? Do brokers leave often for other teams or brokerages? Ask those important questions. And number five, contracts. Read your contracts. Understand your contract. Have a lawyer review the contract. there are some pretty crazy contracts floating around in this business. If it's a BS contract with BS clauses, don't sign up. At the end of the day, this is a business. You are self-employed now. Your brokerage is not your boss. Treat this as a business decision. While there is some room here for emotions like the working environment of your team, there must be a balance where you feel you are getting your money's worth from the team you join. Brokerages are operating a business model. They earn money off you and the business you are doing. Contracts work both ways, and there should always be a balance of what you get for your money and value for your dollars. If you do not feel you are getting value for your money, speak up, then negotiate, or find a new home to hang your license. At Arise Mortgage, I will be the one training you. I will accept and train only one candidate though. I don't just accept anyone. The qualified candidate has to be fully committed and trainable. In exchange, I'm going to pour out my heart as well to train you to ensure you will become a successful mortgage broker. The training consists of a 90 days intensive one-to-one training. It consists of morning routines, mortgage brokering skills, and how to do a file from beginning to end, and sales skills. You're welcome to connect with other brokers on our team to see how they found the training. If you are interested in joining our team, apply by submitting your resume, and let's get connected.